click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Chapter Nature of Chemical Bond, and we are doing the topic Importance and Limitation of Valence Bond Theory. Hey friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that is we did a vast topic that is on the valence bond theory, but now we are going to talk about that what are the importance of valence bond theory and what were the limitations of the valence bond theory, and because of which we are going to do this topic. So let us understand this one. So talking about the importance and the limitation of valence bond theory, so we are going to discuss about, first of all we are going to discuss about the what are the importance thing that we have got to know because of the valence bond theory, and then we are moving towards the limitation. So let us understand what are the importance of VBT. So now talking about the importance of the VBT, that is the valence bond theory. So the first point that we have got to know from there, that is the delocalization of electrons over the two nuclei. So this is the first thing that we have got to know, that is the delocalization of a nuclei also or the electrons over the two nuclei, that also takes place, and because of which the bonding can happen. And this is what we have also understood whenever a covalent bond has been formed, because of the presence of, that is the unpaired electrons, or because of the presence of the valence electrons, so obviously they will combine with each other in such a way that the electrons can be delocalized or can be distributed over the two nuclei, and that is what it has had first importance that we are going to talk about. And talking about the next one that we have, that is shielding effect of electrons. Obviously the electrons are the one that has been that are basically revolving around the nucleus, and moreover we could say that the valence electron or the outermost shell which consists of electron, and that also plays a very vital role basically in the bond formation. But meanwhile the inner electrons, they are playing a very vital role in basically shielding the outermost, or shielding the nucleus from the attraction towards the outermost electron towards that of the nucleus. So that for the electrons also plays a very vital role in shielding effect. So that is what it was been explained because of the VBT, and that also makes us to understand that which one of the atom would be more electronegative or less electronegative, and that makes us to understand also whether the covalent bond is like polar or like a pure non-polar covalent bond. So this all are been because of the importance of VBT that we have discussed in our previous lecture. So now let us talk about the next one, that is the essential covalent character of the bond. So obviously the VBT, that is the valence bond theory, clearly explains that a covalent bond is only formed by sharing of electrons, which consists of basically, suppose if the two of the atoms, they when they are combined with each other, so obviously if they have the number of unpaired electrons, so therefore they will form that kind of valency, and that is how they will form a covalent bond. So this was clearly indicated by the valence bond theory, and that is what it is a very important factor to understand. And now let us move on to the next one, that is the presence of partial ionic nature in a covalent bond. Even this was been explained by the when we have discussed about the VBT. Suppose the example that we have studied about in earlier lecture, that is talking about HF, and HF is the one that is forming covalent bond. But in this case, basically fluorine is more electronegative, so that's the reason that the covalent character is been there, because they are forming a covalent bond because of the sharing of electrons. But meanwhile, when we are talking about fluorine, fluorine is more electronegative, and that's the reason that the covalent character is basically gets reduces, and that's the reason that the polar character of the molecule, it increases, and hence it has been said that the partial ionic nature of the covalent bond is also been observed, and that is what, because of we have understood that the electrons are the one, or they can be that is delocalized to the more electronegative, and that's on, we could say that the ionic character can also be explained because of the VBT. So talking about the fifth point, the concept of resonance and connection between the resonance energy and the molecular stability, that was also been explained by the VBT. And talking about the first one, that is the concept of resonance, obviously the resonance is nothing but the delocalization of electrons, making the atom to be in their own position, and that was been explained because of the valence bond theory. And obviously we have got to know that is the resonance energy, we have discussed this topic earlier also, that is the resonance energy, if it is basically, if it is if it has to be stable, then the energy should be very much less, and that is how we could say that the molecule would be more stable. And this all were being explained might be talking about resonance, the structure or the molecule which exhibit various resonating structures can be more stable, because of which the resonance energy also decreases and the molecular stability increases. So this were all the concepts that were being discussed in the valence bond theory, and that plays a very important factor to understand the nature of the chemical bond, and that was being explained by the VBT that we have discussed over here. But apart from the importance of the valence bond theory, there are also some limitations that were not proved at that time because of this theory, that it has expressed most of the bond nature or most of the chemical bond, the characteristic of a chemical bond. It has explained everything, but still there were some limitations, and what were, let us talk about that. So now talking about the limitation of the valence bond theory, so talking about the first one, that is the VBT, that is valence bond theory, explains the formation of covalent bond by shared pair of electrons. That is true, that is what we have got to learn from the VBT. But offers no explanation of formation of coordinate covalent bond. So that was the limitation of the valence bond theory, because we know that coordinate covalent bond, it forms between a metal and a ligand, and obviously in that case, basically a ligand is the one that completely donates its electron to the metal one, so to the metal ion. So in this case, basically the covalent bond is being formed because of they are sharing electrons. But meanwhile, we could say that the ligands, they donate the electrons towards the metal atom, so as to form a much more stronger kind of bond that is known as coordinate covalent bond. But this was not being explained by the valence bond theory, so that was a bit of limitation of the VBT. But still, the importance that we have got to know. But there are a few improvements that we have did, and we have to understand it. So talking about the next one, that is oxygen molecule. That is, oxygen molecule should be diamagnetic according to the VBT. Obviously, because a substance or a molecule to be that is paramagnetic or ferromagnetic, if we talk in that term, it should consist of the unpaired electrons. And because of we know that is during the bond formation of oxygen and oxygen, no unpaired electrons, and that's the reason that because it doesn't consist any kind of unpaired electrons, so that's why it is not paramagnetic. But meanwhile, it has been found that it is in actual fact it is basically paramagnetic in nature, because the paramagnetic nature always arises when we have at least unpaired electron and they move with a particular spin. So that nature was not being explained because of the VBT, and that was a drawback of it. And let us move on to the next one. So talking about the VBT, that is, the valence bond theory does not explain the bond in the electron deficient molecules like B2H6, like diborane, in which the central atom possesses less number of electrons than that the required of an octet electrons. Obviously, we have discussed in our earlier lecture also, that is in inadequacies of the octet rule. In this case, where we have discussed that there are also certain kind of molecules, they don't have a complete octet, or we could say they have at least incomplete octet, or they have expanded octet, but still those molecules are basically more stable. So therefore, in VBT also we could say that they were not being explained that how the molecule has been stable and how the molecule has been forming a bond in spite of not having the octet electrons or 8 electrons. In fact, they have less electrons than 8 electrons in their outermost shell, but still they are forming the bond. So that was not being explained by the help of VBT. So these were the two things that I want to talk about, that is, one was importance and one was, that is, limitation of valence bond theory. So still there are certain improvements that have been done with the various theory that we have did in our previous lecture. So for now, this is it. Thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know the importance and the limitation of the valence bond theory. So I hope you will share this video with the friends, and just don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.